is our van, which is currently in the middle of Mexico. A few weeks ago, the van broke down and was in need of some massive repairs. So we left it at a local mechanic shop in Mexico and flew home for a bit to see our friends and family because, I mean, what is the worst that could happen, really?
Popocatépetl volcano.
Mexico's most dangerous active volcano.
Belching out poisonous smoke and ashes.
Okay, so maybe we didn't exactly see that one coming. So Vinny is currently in the city of Puebla. That volcano, Popocatépetl, is 40 miles from Puebla and has been spewing ash and lava into the skies for a good few days now. When we first heard there was an actual volcano erupting near Puebla, we were simply relieved that we were at home, safe and sound, on the other side of the world. But then, reality hit us like a flying chunk of volcanic rock. As videos started pouring in, showing massive ash clouds descending upon the city, schools evacuating, and suddenly it dawned on us. Guys, remember our trusty little van, Vinny? The one we call home sweet home? Yeah, that's still in Puebla. Even though our van was parked inside the mechanic shop, it had been covered in a layer of volcanic ash. And as it turns out, volcanic ash isn't exactly a car's best friend. All we could think of was, what if this gets even worse? Now, of course, being the responsible adventurers that we are, we decided to do a bit of Googling. And as it turns out, while the government raised the alarm level to level 3, 4 being the spiciest, life in Puebla seemed to be carrying on mostly as normal. So we thought, hey, let's just take those flights back that we had scheduled in a few days.
We're not even sure if we're going to make it to Puebla because a lot of flights in Mexico have been cancelled due to the volcano erupting, so fingers crossed.
We may have accidentally forgotten to mention the minor detail of an erupting volcano to our families. Whoops.
Ken, what happened to your window seat?
I was super excited to have a window seat, but it's just so beautiful. So yesterday evening we arrived in this hotel room.
Typical Mexican breakfast with chilaquiles. Oh my god, there's so many people here to check in.
There's a flight to Puebla. It says that it's on time.
¿Cómo es el volcán?
Popocatépetl.
Ahorita ya está más calmado porque los días anteriores sacaba mucha ceniza.
Ah, sí, sí, sí.
Caía mucha ceniza.
Sí, sí. Ok.
Pero más en las noches.
Ah, más en las noches.
No, Anel, ¿es humo del volcán?
Ajá, es ceniza la que cae.
Ah, ceniza, sí, sí.
Ah, todo eso es del volcán.
Del volcán.
Wow.
Our brilliant plan of heading to Puebla to rescue our dear Vinny, heading straight toward an erupting volcano, was suddenly becoming very real. As we approached the city we had only just arrived in, we already couldn't wait to leave as soon as possible.
De hecho, la semana pasada habían suspendido clases en las escuelas por lo mismo del volcán de que caía mucha ceniza.
Así sí.
It had been almost 6 weeks now since our van wouldn't start anymore and we had to take Vinny to the garage. At that point, our engine had about as much stamina as a toddler on a sugar rush. It was very bad. Turns out our exhaust system had completely failed and needed replacing, along with some other parts in our AdBlue RDEF system. So the mechanics brought in parts from various nooks and crannies in Mexico, and we shipped some over from Belgium as well. 6 weeks later, we still had not received that long-awaited WhatsApp message that said, hey, everything's fine now, you can come and pick up your van.
¿Cómo estás?
Anything.
So the engine seems to be running again now without stalling, which is really good news, but not so great or weird news to me a little bit. They haven't test driven it yet. Like, so they don't know if like the engine has power now that we can drive again.
Their policy is that you have to pay for the repairs before you get to take the car out. So
we had to pay everything. Ah, home sweet home.
So $180 for mechanics who initially helped me out when I broke down by myself. The Crespo that I bought that $300. Didn't fit. Random screws and bolts and stuff. $300 for additional parts from Belgium. $1,300 for the big part for the exhaust that they ordered here in Mexico. Yep. And then how much did we pay these guys?
Luckily the bill we got was not too bad. $16,000,
$17,500. Pesos. Hotel costs, probably about $500.
Total cost of this van breakdown is about $3,600. Did you count the shipping as well? No. So it's actually $3,800.
So yeah, it's a little bit painful.
It's really painful.
But I mean, we can dwell on this and we can be like, no, the money, yeah, and blah, blah, blah. And
I mean, there was no other option than to get Vinny repaired.
I'm okay with this amount. I mean, obviously it's a load of money, but I'm okay with this if it means he's actually fixed.
Yeah, imagine we pay $3,800 now and the van isn't fixed.
We're gonna watch some Netflix. I just hope we can get out of here tomorrow. I just want to drive the van away from the active volcano.
Good morning. It's currently 6 a.m. I've been up for 2 hours.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
35
years old.
25.
25 with 10 years of experience.
Thank you. To say that I am nervous to go and pick up the van is an understatement. I think it's almost been 6 weeks since we broke down. After all this time and all this money, I can't even put to words how badly I hope that the van will be fine.
Kim, are you seeing what I'm seeing? Seeing what I'm seeing? It's a clean, shiny Vinny. And he's outside, so maybe he's working.
So we just took a test drive together with the mechanic. And
first thing that happened when we turned on the engine was an error code.
It wasn't there yesterday. We saw it.
Check engine light came back on. I was like,
blue.
Can't be serious about this. So back where we started. This is unreal. Kim, what's happening?
That'll be the nerves.
Alright, so we just left the garage. We can spend an hour searching for what the problem could be. It looked like we had to change the NOx sensor, which was, yeah, they had to order it and blah blah blah. But the mechanic was relentless and he checked again. Apparently one small cable is a little bit damaged to the sensor, so he made a repair. And then the error code went away and zero messages active. So I think we're good to go!
Not a big question, of course, is we've had this happen before. Situations where we had a problem, we thought they'd fixed it, it was fine for a while, then it came back. The plan is to drive this baby like a long way. My brain is damaged. What I was trying to say was that in this video, we're gonna put Vinny to the proper test to see if he's truly fixed or not.
My favorite boyfriend ever.
Look at these mountains. Look at this valley that we're in here. It's super foggy, but look how cool the scenery is. And it's so nice to be back on the road again. Our goal is to reach this place, Isla Aguada, an idyllic spot on the Gulf of Mexico with palm trees, beautiful beaches. It looks just like paradise, which is exactly what we need right now. We were unaware that along the way, we'd encounter quite a few more challenges.
We're driving a bit through a central part here in Mexico, which is a little bit of no man's land. There's not much here. In the mountains up here, there's a few towns, basically a lawless place where the cops don't go. And there's a lot of bandits and gangs up there that just come here to hide out in the mountains. And I was just looking on an iOverlander to check for a spot, see if we can have some lunch. I just checked in this town, it doesn't seem safe at all. There's a few warning signs and people have even been robbed here in the past in this area. So I think we're just gonna continue. There's something so weird on this route. There have been so many cars being towed by another car. And then a big letter that says in tow in the back. But it's not like one or two, it's been 15 on like a 10 mile stretch. There's another one right here.
And they all seem to be like these old crappy vehicles. Are they broken? Are they just trying to move two vehicles at once while being efficient? I don't get it. This route is a car breaker, Naick. We need to get out of here.
Ah, no, Vinny!
All right, so we...
We came from 2,000 meters, which is more than 6,000 feet altitude, down to probably closing to sea level. It's now almost 40 degrees. I'm gonna cook up celebratory lunch for Kim. I'm going to be using some lentils as a base for this dish. And we bought some salmon. I bought some grass-fed butter, always really good. Bake your fish in butter. All right, I added some edamame as well. I'm gonna try to add this a little bit in here. Broccoli. I'm gonna cut up some raw veggies to add in the mix as well. Oh, this is gonna be super tasty. So happy I can cook again and make all these nice dishes.
I'm happy you can cook again too.
My lady.
Oh, this smells really good.
Mmm. That's good. Oh. Mmm. That's good, eh? Oh, the AC, I love it.
We figured we would have a michelada, which is essentially beer, but the Mexican version of beer. And what is the Mexican version of anything? They add chili, lime, and a whole bunch of other stuff to it. In this case, clam juice. I know this sounds so wrong, but I mean, why the heck not?
That is good. Really? It's very refreshing. In Belgium, they would take away my passport if they would see me doing this.
Well, I'll be clammed. This is actually really good.
This is a small family-owned restaurant. And they make one thing, which is seafood. They have a bunch of options. We asked, like, what's your specialty? And they said, oh, we make this amazing fish soup with all kinds of fish in it and some cheese. And it's such a rich, thick soup. Mmm.
What an amazing spot. The mosquitoes are eating me alive.
Oh yeah.
You have it too?
This is what I really love about traveling with the van. Like, you get to these spots where nobody else comes.
I love you.
So the goal of today is to get to the Gulf of Mexico, and I found a spot on I Overlanded where other travels share spots. A lot of people have commented in there this was the most beautiful spot they stayed in all of Mexico on their travel. So
on our way to paradise, we decided to make a pit stop at a park to meet some very interesting residents of this part of Mexico. Oh, there's one over there.
Some people call it Andes because they look a bit like Andes, but they're actually called Cuatamundis.
Uh-oh, Kip, this one's coming for you.
This is so cool. I've never seen... What was it called? Cuatis.
According to Mr. Google, they live in Mexico and Central America, but also in the southern states of the US.
How are you doing, sir? Sir?
Not.
Sir? How are you doing?
Sir? This is exactly...
Sir? Are you okay, sir?
How cool is that?
Here we see the rare Kim species. She's performing her 7 times daily ritual, laddering up in an unknown white substance.
I see.
Why is nothing? Oh!
Oh! Yeah. Okay, it's two near collisions in 10 seconds. Oh, the driving is becoming very chaotic here. Like, people are just weaving through, like, there's no rules at all. But the good news is the van's still holding up great, still got a lot of power. You can really feel the difference, so I'm a happy camper. We made it to paradise! And we can pick out our own spot.
Right next to the water. Just look at the palm trees and the nice blue water. And after all the problems that we had with the van, after 6 weeks of the van being in the garage and just worrying so much about if we were even going to be able to continue this trip and everything, it's just, I almost can't put to words how relieved I am right now. And it's finally time to just enjoy the van.
Wow. Good morning, guys. Currently 6:30 a.m. I've been up since 6 a.m. preparing all my stuff to do something I've been wanting to do for months now. Started inflating the boat and I figured maybe I should read the manual. I bought this kayak almost 3 months ago and I haven't had the opportunity yet to try it out, but now I've fully set it up, got my seat ready, got my two fishing rods. Good to go, living the dream.
Here we go. First part of the trip at the kayak. Oh, this is so comfortable. Oh. That's the spot we're going fishing, next to those bridges, because that's where the fish are supposed to be. Dun, 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 fishing, fishing, fishing.
Just look at that, guys. It's like there's a bunch of tiny dinosaurs basically walking around here on the lawn. Oh, he was really chasing the other lizard, iguana, I'm not sure. Oh, that's really cool. There's like 5 of them here. They look so, so cool. Wow. Just casually observing them here on the campsite. Those are sometimes the best wildlife viewings, the ones that you don't expect.
Got a fish on. Ooh, there we are. There's gonna be a tasty fish for tonight. Oh, I can see him jumping. You guys see that? It's a ladyfish. That's a cool fish. These are really bad eating, so I'm gonna put it back. Look at those teeth though. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Got some cool fish today.
Oh, what is that?
I think it's like a sea bass or sea trout or something. I'm not entirely sure.
These guys want a picture with Naick and the fish as well.
Corvina.
Carvina, okay.
Corvina.
¿Es muy rico?
Sí.
Sí,
oh. Frito, en caldo, está riquísimo.
Oh, qué bueno.
Oh. Thank God for fans. So I was just thinking to myself that, damn, I haven't been this hot in a really, really long time. It turns out today is a whopping 37 degrees Celsius, which is coming up on 100 Fahrenheit.
Sitting outside in the shade, it's still really, really hot. I'm just sweating profusely.
Doing nothing. It's a big adjustment.
I feel like a chicken sitting in a warm oven. I think I know. I think I know the solution. I've got a really big bag of ice. I dropped it though. Ice cold drinks.
Oh, that's so satisfying.
This is better than sex.
It is.
There's a few peppers around. I think it's gonna be hot for them too, so I'm gonna give them.
Two thumbs up.
It is so shallow here. It is low tide.
The worst part is it's not refreshing at all. It's disappointing.
But it's still fun.
But at least we're in the water. A little bit of sun. Hello, my hairy friend. First things first. Two thumbs up.
Okay, time for a little magic. First. I'm gonna rub these little babies with some garlic.
You have cheese on your head.
I can explain. Making some bruschettas. You want one?
Ah, yes, I want one.
Here you go.
Thank you. Thank you, my friend.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Look at those beautiful sunset colors. We have my favorite person in the world.
I'm gonna start by dicing up the raw tuna. Add in some avocado, finely chopped onion, soy sauce, pepper, a good scoop of Dijon mustard. And I'm gonna add in a little bit of toasted sesame oil and some lime. And then we are going to mix it all up in the bowl. And since we are in Mexico, a little bit of, come on, bowl up here.
Oh, I feel like I've already forgotten all about the van trouble. What volcano eruption?
Yeah, I mean, it's completely gone now from my mind, so.
I think that is something that the van breakdowns have taught us. If everything goes right all the time, it would hardly be an adventure to drive from Alaska to Argentina. And it's not fun when things go wrong, whether that's a van breakdown or a volcano eruption or something else. But it's part of it.
Yeah, and I feel like after being stuck and going home and now coming back, I appreciate even more like the travels that we do and everything.
Living the dream.